What's up, everybody? We are now working on our Mandalorian pelvis and leg armor, starting from the feet, working up. I have the Django style feet armor that goes over the boot. I am currently sanding down all the original work done to it, courtesy of J2SO. But that's what I'm working on right now, just getting it sanded up. Basically, we're just making that nice and round and flush. Now we're working the Django style shin armor. Just working it back down to smooth, taking out any rough edges, rough patches, things that I just don't want in there. One thing that sounds silly that I like to do is I like to not look at it and then run my finger across it, and that helps me find any imperfections, because if you're looking at it, you're like, well, all that's imperfections, and it's not. That's all flat, which is what you want. So anything that's got humps, lumps, anything like that. And same thing with our thigh armor. And this is our Django style pelvic armor. Same thing. All right, everybody, it's a little bit windy out today, but we're gonna get the primer down on our leg armor using our Rust-Oleum primer. So I'm not gonna bore you with painting, but I'll show you the end.
Here's primer over the first half of the leg armor. And pelvis and thighs, looking good primed.
All right, so we're letting our leg armor primed now sit overnight to dry, and we'll be hitting it with that silver metallic to create the Beskar effect, so stay tuned. All right, everyone, so we are gonna be hitting this with our metallic silver to give that Beskar finish. I'm not gonna film me painting it. I'll show you after the coats are on. It's gonna look a little different than the flak vest because I'm very low on paint, but I don't need to go buy any, because all you need this for is the spots that you plan on having the Beskar bleed through the paint. So really the edges, and I have a few predetermined spots on the armor itself that I'm gonna have it bleed through. So
I'll show you a real tutorial. I ran out sooner than I thought I wanted to, but I have plan B. So I'm gonna take this silver acrylic and hand paint basically the areas of damage I want underneath. Exact same process that we did on the flak vest, except for it's a hand-painted acrylic instead of a spray.
So watched our previous video on the painting with the flak vest, but this is different. We're just hitting this with some acrylic, man. Doing this on the fly, it's gonna work fine, because like I said, you're only gonna see 10% of everything I'm applying anyways. But acrylic has such a cool finish. This silver will look awesome. Basically, man, yeah, that's what we're doing. We're just going around it like this, adding in where I plan on having some of that damage show. Like I said, it's maybe gonna be 10% of this, so. Gives you a good color though.
Here it is with pure silver acrylics on both. A little bit of a different set. It's almost like a Django finish on color, like Jango Fett's Beskar. Looks cool. I actually think doing it this way looks more accurate to Beskar, but this is, I don't recommend this. It is a pain to hand paint these. But it's gonna look good, because like I said, only 90% of this, or I'm sorry, about 10% of this is gonna be visible. The other 90 is getting covered up anyways. So next step, let these dry for a day, and then we'll toothpaste where we want Beskar to be exposed. So stay tuned for that.
Today we're gonna start working on toothpasting and weathering our armor. That acrylic is nice and dried. Looks pretty good on there. I'll show you some pictures of that. But without further ado, let's get to work on it. Same thing, if you watch the flak vest video and you're tuning in for part two, same exact principles. Nothing has changed, except I have not disintegrated this paintbrush. So we're gonna use a medium paintbrush. But same idea, we're just applying that toothpaste, making it look good, chipping away at that armor. You're just trying to envision, what do you want this to look like? where do you want your wear to be? Where do you want stuff to show underneath? That is really all we're doing. And it is worth noting that you can do this with liquid latex, I believe is what a lot of people are doing. That costs money. I'd like to spend money on other things, personally, but liquid latex is one way to do this. But look, man, this works just fine. Toothpaste, and a paintbrush. I guess I could use a toothbrush. Maybe we'll try that on another project, huh? These are made out of metal. I've never toothpasted metal before. Maybe this is where the liquid latex is better. I don't know, we're gonna find out, but we're not changing anything. We're just doing the exact same process, just a little different material. It'll be cool to see this finish on some metal. All right, so we are all toothpasted up. Things are looking good. I like to let that sit just for a few minutes. And if this weather will calm down a little bit, it's a little windy today. I'm gonna try to beat the rain. I'd like to get some paint on it. We're gonna go with the black. And because of my accident on the flak vest, I'm gonna mix in a little bit of brown, just get that black brown going again. So
pretty windy out here, but we're gonna hit it with the black matte, go over this set, and we're gonna hit it with the brown next.
Next up is our Krylon brown. That's gonna go over this already laid down black. And then a bit more black for the third coat. And then we do it again. All right, so we have our pieces with three coats. It is two of black, one of brown, nice little mix. Again, you're only gonna see maybe 10% of this, but I love what it does underneath if you saw my flak vest video, so it'll all make sense. It's adds that extra layer of depth and effort. When you look at the armor, you know, like, hey, whoever made this went to the extra step to spend all the time to apply that extra coat in between, so it really brings out those damage.
So we're gonna be getting all the toothpaste off of these, and these are the metal knees. I use a toothbrush, it works really well, I'll show you. You can see how that's starting to come away and create that weathering line. There you have it. That's how you do these.
All right, so we have removed all the toothpaste from the black brown, and that exposes that Beskar weathering. What's nice about this method is that I can reapply and kind of even out, like, see how this one has more than this one. I want that similar, so I'm gonna go back in and touch that up more. Cod plate or cod piece, love what I'm getting out of that. That's sweet, and those built-in dents, keeping those. Good example here, thighs. This is ideal level. This is too much. So I can fix that. Knees came out great. Loving both of those. But yeah, basically you're gonna fill back in what you have and then go from there.
All right, so we are gonna do round two toothpasting. Basically we went through, painted that black brown over the previous toothpaste, figured out what the damage is gonna look like through this layer. And I really want to perfect it so that when we go back in with the tan, we have that toothpaste applied. And this is an extra step you don't have to do, which we did, but really lets you be in control of the level of damage. And you can actually see the product as you're going as opposed to the end. So I do peel it twice. But I like it that way. I think it looks better. So touching this one up, this one's got too much wear. So we're gonna be extra careful on these to make sure we do them right.
Alright, so we are re-toothpasted and we are about to hit with tan. We've got a couple coats of tan down. We're gonna let these sit a minute, add a third, and then swap over to the next piece.
And there we have our tan. Looking good, we're gonna let that dry. All right, so these are tan. They got about two to three coats on each. They're sitting nice and dry, all that unevenness is our toothpaste. That has that Beskar finish and that black brown underneath. So should look good, and let that cure and dry for about a full 24 hours. And then we'll peel our toothpaste and see where we're
at. So we're gonna begin taping off the lower leg armor, cod piece, etc., to get ready for the charcoal gray detail paintwork. And here you have it. Everything is nice and taped off. All that tan is gonna become dark charcoal gray, and then everything that is blue will go back to the tan, and it's gonna look really sweet. So let's get ready to paint. About to hit the cod piece and the shins with the gloss protective enamel charcoal gray. There's our first coat, letting that bake in this hot Florida sun, and then we're gonna hit coats two and three. And we are drying, it's three coats, so we're gonna let that sit overnight, and then we'll peel, and we will see the pre-weathering, what it looks like.
Pre-tape pull. Once this is pulled, this look, again, could be considered final. But I like to add the weathering, and I have to compliment the rest of my armor at this point, but yeah, once you reveal it, it could be considered done.
Tape removed, pre-toothpaste wipe. There's still white on there, which is toothpaste. A lot of it was pulled away by the tape, but I'm pleased so far with what I am seeing. Cod came out pretty legit. All my designs stayed how I wanted them. Yeah, let's get with the toothpaste removed. You could consider this done. It looks pretty sick. This is gonna get further weathered with the black brown wash, but yeah, there it is. Nice dents, everything came out good. All right, what's up everybody? Got our fantastic pre-brown black wash leg armor ready for our weathering. I'll show you what we're gonna do. We're gonna take this brown and black acrylic. I'm gonna mix it with this water, and you apply it with a brush of your choice to said piece, and you let it sit for not too long, maybe a minute at most is what I like to do. Make sure it gets in those cracks of the damage and the layers, and you wipe it away with paper towels. So I will briefly show you what that looks like. Oh, there's my lesson. I wear gloves now. Last time I did this, not so fun. My entire hands were black and brown. So, we're gonna wear gloves now. This part's not too hard. So we're gonna start with our boot armor, if you wanna call it that. Many ways to do this, but what I do is I take my brush and I will start with the black. So get a good black. And then I come over to my water, get my water going, and I just start applying. And there's no rhyme or reason, it's just cover, 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 cover. Add a little more water to break up the thickness of the paint, it goes further. Less dips, more, it's good. Don't want to waste paint for no reason. Gloves, man, lifesaver for what we're doing right now. But basically just cover the surface area. Get it in them cracks, good. Water. Cross around, the front's good. Looking good. Shake that brush out a little bit. Give it just a second here. Grab our handy dandy paper towel. And then give it the white, the wash. Rinse and repeat, right? That's all this is. Rinse and repeat. But first layer, already liking it. Big time already liking it. So this is the final product we have here. We went a little darker than anticipated, so we took sandpaper to it and brought back some of the darkness. That also
brought in a little bit of an extra weathering effect that I had not planned on doing, which was the sandpaper against the material, which creates scratches, like real-world scratches, so I love how that came out. This will accent and complement the chest armor and helmet very, very well, so this full costume is well on its way. Let me know what you guys think about this video. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We plan on doing more of this stuff in the future. We'll have some exclusive Patreon stuff coming your way. But that is all I have for now. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you learned something. Please let me know what I can do better. And as always, may the Force be with you. Always.